So the following has been taken from the official World of Tanks console stream that was on the 3rd of May. I've picked out the part that they discussed about Marks of Excellence. So do a bit of a some feedback whilst we go along. All right.
I know this is probably a little bit big because this is on my 2K screen. So this was the survey that was sent out for the English.
So I actually got the survey.
It was completed 7,400 times. Which means it has a 98.8 completion rate. So around, I don't know how much exactly, but from what I know, that I think around 1 million plus minus, I think even more, unique links were created for the survey. So it was a lot, but from the people who opened it, they, you know, 98% completed it. That is the English one. So around 68% said yes, they know.
See, obviously I answered yes for the first one.
Said nope, we don't. Once you answered no, the survey ended.
So it's quite good to get confirmation of that. So if people didn't know what it was,
been responded by
didn't ask any more questions, that's pretty good.
Excellence are. From around 89% said that they already had earned marks of excellence.
Yes, for this one.
48% said yes, they are actively going for.
So I said no for this one.
51%
said
no.
I'm not actively trying for marks of excellence anymore.
And now we come to the part with the difficulty. So
I put too difficult.
40% said it's too difficult. 58% said it's about right. Please don't say I'm muted again. Okay, I'm
no, good.
Okay, Hellcat will leave us for today, unfortunately, but it's fine. It's okay, Hellcat. Thank you for joining, as always.
I was going to edit this out, but I left it in as one.
Because sometimes I touch the mic
just so I'm not accused of editing it in a certain way to cut things out. So yeah, just let it run.
He just wrote me a message that there was something coming up, unfortunately, and he needed to go. So around 58% said it's about right, and 1.6% said it's too easy. Now you can combine these numbers if you want or not. But it shows me that there's still, I will explain it later, what I think about these numbers. When it comes to the motivation.
So for this one, I put not motivated.
50% said that they are somewhat motivated.
Yeah, I'm just not motivated to do marks of excellence anymore.
Said they are not motivated, and 22% said they have
been playing Cold War recently. And I've just been going for one marks. They just come during the grind.
When we're talking about
the marks, and then I just leave it there.
We had three goals, because it's very difficult to explain to the average players who do not know what marks of excellence are or have.
I think that's one of their issues. They don't know, how to explain it.
The old and the new system.
And I'm not too sure if average players are particularly interested. I was never really interested in marks of excellence.
I know, in the meantime, a lot of these, a lot of the opinions from different players. So our three goals. What we try to achieve is the general awareness of marks of excellence.
There's no in-game guide about marks of excellence.
The average perceived difficulty of marks of
excellence. That's very subjective.
Which is this. And the average perceived motivation as a third.
Again, another subjective.
I also received a lot of feedback regarding the questions that they were not, that we didn't have a, you know, big enough variety when it comes to that, but
I think that's true.
We could have, of course, used the survey with a one page of explanation what the differences are, but then I can assure you that this would have been,
yeah, that's the problem. If they sent 1 million out and they got 7,500 responses,
they would have read it, and
I can imagine if they had a massive survey
and
they wouldn't have got the feedback.
Not to say anything bad against anyone, that's just the world that we live in. Like, on how many occasions do you actually fill out a survey when it's more than one page?
That's, yeah, I mean, that's true,
like,
isn't it?
I play from experience. I talk from experience. Sometimes I take the time to fill out a survey because I'm just generally interested in it. But when it comes to just an opinion, was this a good experience? Yes, no, okay, done. I never received an email on this poll. That's another whole different topic. And I don't know why people didn't receive it. Like, I had a handful of Germans approach me and said they didn't receive it. And I don't know why.
That's... It could be because they turned off their email subscriptions.
Yeah,
it
can be.
They log in via the website and go into the account management at the bottom of the website. They can have a look to see if their email subscriptions include surveys.
Yeah. Mr. SPG, not even spam filters. I had people that said they checked all their spam. It's not in there. They just generally didn't receive it. My takeaways from this is, because I also, I talk a lot with players, I interact with the players, and I sit with them and I play with them. And they also came to me and said, like, well, Chris, with the questions about the motivation, I would have liked to have the choice of very motivated, somewhat motivated, not motivated, and I once was motivated, but I'm not anymore.
That's the fourth option I was thinking.
So, yeah, it's a takeaway that I mean...
When I was answering that question. I'm somewhat motivated to get one marks. Not motivated to get three marks anymore. So, somewhere in the middle of somewhat motivated in the past.
Yeah, exactly. That's another topic. And another question is that And maybe another takeaway is to somehow... communicate it via in-game, you know, make these polls.
Yeah, they could have a link in-game. Not too sure how it'd work. Probably just through the browser, at least on PlayStation.
So players can just,
they can link, when they log in, you press a certain button, it'll boost up the browser.
Poll, yes or no?
I'm not too sure how it works on Xbox, but on PlayStation at least. They do it for the drop tables, for the key cards. You can just press triangle, and it takes you to the website and shows you the drop tables for the key cards. So they could do something similar like that, at least for PlayStation.
So regarding the complaints, Max Minor Tanker, that is not something that... Like, when I talked to the players, it was not something that was complained about. The whole issue is that with the 6.0 update, the
6.0 just broke everything, didn't it?
Of the marks of excellence were just wrong. And in the last summer, these calculations were adjusted so they are actually what they reflected in game.
I'm sure at the time they said they were taking out the map weighting or something.
Why there are a lot of...
So now they're saying it's reverted to pre-6.0. Yeah, I'm not too sure.
First mark is easy to get, third mark is impossible. And that is something as well. In the survey,
I think that's my opinion
of
it now as well. I think the first mark sort of comes along naturally, especially on a long tech tree grind.
The issue is that the CCs and other World of Tanks users send out their own poll. Yes and no. First of all, that poll was my idea. I created this to get a collective awareness on this topic so I can move forward and do this poll. I understand what the stance of the core community is.
I think what he's trying to say is that he knows what the vocal core, people are saying about Mark Spector. He just wants to see what the wider audience of this game thinks about it.
People see how much you do actually argue for things for them. And yet we're sat in a call all day and we're constantly talking about these topics and what needs bringing up again and how we can communicate it a bit more clearly so that we can get it through and we can start pushing for these things.
Yeah. And regarding the CC poll, like, don't get me wrong, I'm defending this. And I mean, I know, I see what the community wants. The problem is that you also need to understand, if you have a poll, and again, that was my idea, my mistake, if you want to blame someone, blame me. if you do a poll on,
I think polls are always a good idea. It's never a mistake to do a poll.
You have like, you know, 500 votes there. You have 1,000 votes on Discord, you know, up and down votes. And then you have like 300 on their YouTube channel, 400 on this tweet. It doesn't mean that you have like 4,000 combined votes.
That is true. I mean, it, you know, you can have, vote one a certain way. I mean, your, on Discord, your Discord, your Twitter, your Facebook people, profile, the in-game profile. So I can understand could be what you're saying, but why didn't they just put a link up on Twitter or Discord
so spread out and everybody can vote to a link
with this poll?
I personally like to have one,
and you had to, you know, you have to log into your Wargame account. So that's how you can make sure people only vote once.
In these kind of surveys, where
so I think they may have missed a trick with that.
Everybody can only vote once. So yeah. Also, here are the German numbers. There we had a, you know, 99.2 completion rate. German efficiency, as always, you know.
hey, English wasn't that far off.
Yeah. So, weißt du, was Erfolgsmarkierungen sind? Do you know what marks of excellence are? Nein! Yeah. No, but it's quite similar. So if you, for example, look at the difficulty, you have 60% in the Germans say it's about right. 38% say it's too difficult. So you see, like,
this is quite interesting to see how the sort of different.
It's very similar.
So countries view
and,
these.
Regarding the motivation, you have 50-49, 23-28. This is the only thing where it varies a lot, where it differs.
Again, motivation is a objective thing. So.
Like, Germans are apparently more
could be
motivated.
Just a difference in countries on that. So, yeah, a bit subjective, that last question. But yeah, it'd be interesting if they could just put up the pie charts of the other languages. I'm sure they don't have anything to hide with that. I'm sure they're all similar, but it'd be just interesting if they could put up
numbers. So,
just a pie chart of the other languages.
Talked about on Friday. Those are the numbers from the email survey. I need to put an emphasis on this because there is a difference between the community survey and the actual email survey. And but yeah.
So yeah, that was the only part of the live stream I watched. I put this video together because I really do quite like the mechanic of these marks of excellence. It's a really good part of the game. It's a kind of a motivation to sort of play, to try and sort of master tanks and master the play styles. And I think the marks of excellence really do encourage that with a reward, you know, marks on the barrel. I can understand what they're saying, that maybe, you know, they've gone back on the calculation, another thing that 6.0 apparently broke, but I'm not too sure how many different explanations I've heard now. I always thought it was some weighting that they put in that they've removed with 6.0. So, yeah, it just seems to be changing their tune with what the change was. I understood that they put a map weighting in, so on more difficult maps for the tank, the requirements were lower or something along those lines, and they removed that. I think what really needs to probably change is the fourth marks of excellence. Twofold, really. One, a free mark in a tank isn't the pinnacle anymore. The second one, the fourth mark really does encourage the really good players to just constantly play the same tank over and over, getting really, really good games over and over again. And what that does is it increases the, essentially the average of the tank, or the 100% mark, which gives a knock-on effect of making all the other marks more difficult to get. So yeah, I think they've kind of messed up the marks of excellence in this game. If they wanted to go back to the old calculation, or whatever the story is next about how they were, that's fine. But I think the mistake probably was the fourth marks. I think it's just very gimmicky. I can understand that maybe people do want something for getting to 100%. I definitely have the opinion that potentially a unique camouflage for the tank, or some sort of inscription or emblem or something along those lines. So yeah, if you've made it this far through the video, by all means, please do comment. I am interested to know what everyone else's opinions of Marks of Excellence is, and what your suggestions would be, or if you agree with mine. So yeah, thank you so much for watching.